Now, being as we're sort of finishing, as we do here, you need to pilfer our shelves.
I've got my eye on a good...
Do you want to come over here? Now, people right, here, okay, Nick's just moving the camera here. Now, Nick's all over the place. This is a new set, you may have realised. Why do you want that?
Sorry, what?
You can't have everything. You can have a few bits and pieces.
Definitely.
Do you want your telly? Can we take your telly?
You can't have the telly. No, Mirror Group are watching this. Al, no.
I want to take over the world.
You want the furniture? It's from a famous Swedish company.
I'll be without a cricket bat, that's what I say. Yeah. Oh, mug of tea for the morning when we get up really early. What do you think? What do you reckon? Yeah.
Do you want a cushion as well? There you go. You want the seat? Hold on.
Yeah, come on, carry it, man.
I can't quite lift. I'll tell you what.
Put your camera down and help us. Come on.
Tell you what, you just pilfer the whole set. We're going to go and take this little tape in to be edited now because it's a bit of a rush. So come on, down here, Nick. Jump, jump, jump around. Jump, jump, jump. We are now taking this to our little editor, Louise. She doesn't know we're doing this. But, Louise, why are you sat over there? You've spoiled the gag. Come and edit the tape. Quick. And as if by magic, Louise is ready for the tape! Now, if you aren't lucky enough to have tickets for the second Cher concert on the 8th of December at the NEC, don't worry, you could be watching the show in the comfort of your own living room. To win a copy of the new Cher Live in Las Vegas video, out next Monday on Warner Home Video, simply tell us the name of her 6 weeks at number one hit from last year. Call us now on 234-5901. That's 234-5901. Leave the answer, your name and number, and we'll put you in the draw.
People have a certain expectation of you, and so they either got it right or they got it wrong. In fact, they all got it wrong. And so then now it's kind of a nicer situation because people either like me or don't, and that's fine.
Join us on the show today, a well-respected name and a songwriter, and what can I say, the new single from him is great. Bernard Butler, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Thanks for us. Oh, yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
Good
fine.
Stuff. A bit more stripped down this time. Apparently you wanted to disperse with the strings and the 48-track mixing and go to something a bit more simplistic.
Yeah, well, once you do things like that, then you kind of... It would be stupid to just keep... Well, lots of people do, keep recurgitating, and so, I've done something different on every record I've made. So that was the plan this time. Basically, I got used to the idea of using strings for melodies and for textures and things and giving it an uplifting feel, and I wanted to be able to work out how to do that without using strings.
In terms of songwriting, though, obviously you've been the group setting in Suede, and then you've done the duet setting with McCormack as well. What's it like actually being in full control of that, where you can do what you like?
It's easy to say, oh, you're in control, which is kind of a negative thing. It seems a negative thing, but actually it's a really good thing for somebody to have a vision when you're doing something creative, and everybody has to sort of cling on to that. And I've got plenty of ideas, so it's a great situation at the moment. I can do this, and then I can do something else if I want to.
How easy is it to carry on being the family man as well while you're doing this music industry thing?
Well, when you're out promoting and stuff, it's not very nice because I'm away. But the way I see it is, basically, if I was doing a 9-to-5 job, I'd never see them. Most people never see their kids when they've got 9-to-5 jobs. That's just fact. It's just a myth that you do.
Has that had any influence on your writing now?
I wouldn't like to try and write lots of soppy songs about my boy and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, it does. It makes me, it gives you a sense that you have to be very unselfish. Yeah.
about the new album, first of all, because I know you've been working hard on that for quite some time, haven't you?
Yeah, it's called Friends and Lovers. It's out in October, and if you go on the website, you can listen to it as many times as you want. In fact, you can tape it, you know, you can easily record things off a computer anyway, so if you want to do that, kids, do it.
BernardButler.com.
Yeah, I thought it would be cool to do something where you just give away a record for nothing. And it's not just a silly acoustic track or a cover version. It's the title track from the album. It's going to be in a single next year anyway. And I thought, why not give people a free record for nothing? That's a brilliant record.
Anyway, you're going to play us a track from your new album. Tell us about the track.
It's called I'd Do It Again If I Could. What about it? It's about doing anything for the person you love.
Right, now at this point in the show, normally we would be previewing Tony Butler's sports special tonight, but I'm afraid rather appropriate as it's Bonfire Night, live TV has finally gone up in smoke.
Yes, indeed. This is our very last broadcast. I'm afraid live TV is closing down. We'd both like to thank you all for your support over the years. Right, also for watching our programmes, and we've endeavoured to bring you the very best of sport, entertainment, news from Birmingham. Can we say to you all, thank you very much indeed, and goodbye.
Thanks for watching. Goodbye. On any further developments on that one. Well, that's my last ever Face Facts, but I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have, and that's also your lot for now, but stay cool. It's hot in studio today. I'm sweating like a poker, which is more than I can say for my mates in our native Yorkshire. It's grim up north, as they say. It's windy and wakey, dull in Hull, drizzly in Driffield, flooding in Farley, shower in Sheffield, and it's damp in Donny. By boom, it's bleak in Barnsley and Hull. So if you're thinking of heading up M1 to visit our friends at North, you can think again, because you'll get absolutely drenched, and it's certainly sunny in Scunny, as they say. Anyway, Wayne from Selby, thanks awfully for your email. My daddy works down the pits too. Dreadful business during the miners' strike. Lucky for that Arthur Scargill fellow, say what? He certainly did save the day. By the way, do you like this new bikini? I bought it yesterday. Does my bum look big in it? Tally hair, old chaps. See you again next time.
Attention, attention, calling all live TV viewers. Yes, all four of you. We have an important announcement. This will affect you.
Live TV, the ship has finally sunk.
Yeah, but you're all right because you're wearing a life jacket.
Well, I'm sure we're all going to be all right. Of course, I'm Helen Gibson. This is Anne-Marie Foss. We're familiar faces of live TV, but the people who count and the people who've made it happen over the years are, of course, all these people here. I'm sure I'm not just speaking for myself. Over the last 5 years, we've thoroughly enjoyed making programmes for you. We've had a laugh, and we hope we've made you laugh too. On this earth can you get such original programming. It's been absolutely marvellous working here. But I'd like to thank the viewers, and I'm sure everyone would, for sticking with us and for increasing the viewership over the years. So thanks to all the staff, thanks to you lot out there, thanks to the management. You never see these guys, they pay our wages at the end of the day. It's been great, but always look on the bright side of life. We're going to be back on other channels all over the place. You can't get rid of us yet.
And thank you all very much.